Good morning class. So this is the fourth class of insurance claim of loss of stock. Today I will discuss regarding the adjustments of abnormal loss item, and on that basis I will discuss a sum on that point of view. So today my sum is sum number 17. I think I have already been given in you provide you the sum number 17 already in the group. So go through that sum, although I will be discussing the sum now, and while solving also I will be helping out. It says that Paul and company suffered a loss of stock due to fire on 16/8/2015, means 16th of August 2015, they suffered the loss of stock. From the following information, prepare a statement showing the claim for the loss of submitted. Okay, you have to find out the statement of loss of stock by file. Cost, stock at cost on 1/1/14, 73,500, it's an opening stock. Stock at cost on 31/12/14, it's a closing stock. Purchase less returns for the year ended 31st December 2014, total purchase has been given, and sales of total year ended has been given, means now you need to prepare a trading account as the total purchase and total sales and opening and closing stock has been provided. Purchase less returns due from the date of fire means during that period purchase has been given, and also during that period sales has been provided. In valuing stock for the balance sheet at 31st of December 2014, rupees 2300 has been written off certain stock which was a poor selling line, means totally rupees 2300 has been write off from the closing stock as it was a poor stock, means abnormal goods, means from the closing stock you need to deduct this 2300 while preparing the trading account, which was a poor selling line having a cost of 6900. Okay, 6900 is the cost, means the cost is 6900 and the abnormal selling call is 2300, means abnormal loss of goods has to be deducted from the closing stock, which is 2300 minus 6900, means 6900 minus 2300, whatever it will be coming, we have to deduct that from the closing stock, and rupees 6900 directly should be deduct from the purchases which has been given for the year, as it has been given as the cost of abnormal goods, which is 6900. A portion of these stocks were sold in March 15 at a loss of 300 on the original cost of 3500. Okay, you are selling at a loss of 300 on the original cost 3500, means while you are preparing the memorandum trading account, you have to deduct this from the sales of memorandum trading account, which is 231,200 minus abnormal loss of sale of goods, which is the cost price is 3500 minus 300, means 3200 has to be deducted from the memorandum trading account. This is how comes the abnormal stock entry. You have to identify which stock from where you have to deduct. The purchase have to deduct the original value, which is 6900. Same wise, the stock, the closing stock has to be deducted from the balance, means 6900 minus 2300, which has been given. Now again, for selling estimated original cost 3500 having a loss of 300, means 3200 has to be deducted from the sales of memorandum trading. The remainder of the stock was now estimated to be the worth of the original cost. Okay, subject to the above expectations, gross profit has remained at a uniform rate throughout. Gross profit has remained at a uniform rate throughout. Uniform rate throughout. So the company has a fire policy of rupees 43,500. Fire policy of 43,500 means the company has a policy value of 43,500. Okay. So, covering its stock of goods, the policy is subject to average clause. The policy has been subject to average clause. The stock salvaged from fire has been valued at rupees 6,000. Means the value of stock which has been saved, which is 6,000. Now you have to construct the insurance claim from here. So in this case, when we are doing the sum, first of all, we have to here, there is no rate of GP has been mentioned. So when there is no rate of GP has been given, you have to calculate the rate of GP. And how you can calculate the rate of GP from here? For that purpose, you need to calculate the trading account. From the trading account, you can calculate the rate of GP. So I am doing this sum. See, sum number 17. So trading account for the year ended. Trading account for the year ended 31st of December 2014, which has been given, right? Make two columns, two amount columns. It will be better. Okay. So here, opening stock has been given to opening stock. What is the amount given? 73,500, right? Purchase less return for the year 3,98,000. Two purchases. 3,98,000. Why? I put this, I will come to the information given below in the sum. Sales total has been given 4,87,000. So by sales is 4,87,000. Okay. Closing stock has been given, which is 79,600. By closing stock, which is 79,600. Now come to the line, in valuing stock from balance sheet at 31st of December 2014, rupees 2,300 has been written off certain stock which was a poor selling line having cost rupees 6,900. Means value of abnormal goods which has been provided over here is rupees 6,900 original, and what is the abnormal price is rupees 2,300. Means 6,900 minus 2,300, it is coming 4,600. That is the value of abnormal stock. You have to deduct from 79,600, it is coming 75,000. And from here also, you have to deduct cost of abnormal goods, which is 6,000. Because the original goods cost is 6,000 and it has been included in the purchase. So, cost of abnormal goods has to be deducted, the original cost, which is 6,900 from the purchase also. Means 3,98,000 minus 6,900, it is coming 3,91,100. Okay. Now see, sales and closing stock has been given, opening stock and purchase has been given. Now you can calculate the gross profit from here. You know how to calculate the gross profit. I think you have computed final accounts in class 12, you know how to compute the gross profit. The balancing figure will be the gross profit. To gross profit, it will be the balancing figure. So it will be 4,87,000 plus 75,000. It is coming 5,62,000. And
If you deduct 5,62,000 from 73,500 minus 3,91,100, we are getting 97,400 as the GP. As we know the GP, now we have to calculate the rate of GP. Rate of GP, how you can calculate the rate of GP? GP by sales into 100. That is the formula. You know, GP by sales into 100 is the value, how you can calculate the rate of GP. You know the GP now, 97,400. Sales is 4,87,000. If you multiply it by 100, you will get the percentage. It is 20%. Rate of GP is 20%. Okay. Now, on this basis, we can calculate memorandum trading account. Up to the date of fire, obviously, for the period 1/1/15 to 16/8/15, right? You can calculate the memorandum trading account now. There is no issues. Particulars, amount rupees. Particulars, amount rupees. Okay. Now, the closing stock, this closing stock will be the opening stock of memorandum trading account, as the year has been closed on 31st December and it starts with 1st of January 15. So, the previous closing stock will be the opening stock over here. To opening stock, which is 75,000 from the closing stock you are getting from the previous year. And purchase has been given during that period, which is 1,62,000. So, to purchases, which has been given 1,62,000, no issues of it. And sales also has been provided, which is 2,31,200. Although there has been a certain twist in it, so I will be putting it in the inner column, which is 2,31,200. Why? Because it has been given that a portion of these goods were sold in March. A portion has been sold in March at a loss of 300 on the original cost of 3,500. The original cost value is 3,500 and it has been suffering a loss of rupees 300. So in that case, what can I do for you that if the original cost value is 300, means it has been suffered a loss of rupees 300. So we will deduct this from the sales. How? What we have to write? Sale price of abnormal goods. Sale price of abnormal goods. How you can compute? Rupees 3500 minus 300, which is the loss, which is 3200. You can deduct from here and it is coming 2,28,000, the sales. Okay, and how you can calculate the GP over here? As you get the GP percentage, 20%. Now you know GP is based on sales, so on sales value we can compute the GP rate and we will get the GP. How? See, to gross profit the percentage is coming 20%, right? 20% of sales. Sales means, that is, what is the value of sales? Rupees 2,28,000, right? So I write it over here, 20% of sales, which is 2,28,000. So 2,28,000 into 20%, we are getting 45,600 as your sales. Now you will get closing stock as the balancing figure. By closing stock, which will be definitely the balancing figure, right? So calculate this. 75,000 plus 45,600 plus 1,62,000. The total is coming 2,82,600. So total is 2,82,600. And if you deduct this 2,28,000, you are getting 54,600 as the closing stock.
54,600 as the closing stock. So now when we will be proceeding towards statement showing the loss of stock, we have to write the closing stock, that is the value of stock on the date of fire till now is 54,600. Now we have to adjust the abnormal goods. Obviously abnormal goods have to be added. What is the actual original value of abnormal goods? See, the original cost has been given first is 6,900 and the selling of original cost is given 3,500. If we deduct the original cost value with the sales of original cost value, we will get the actual abnormal goods value, which has to be added back with the closing stock value. So what we can do now? Now we have to draw the statement showing the loss of profit. I hope the first portion has been completed. So I am rubbing it off and I will show the statement of loss of profit, right? Right. See, statement showing the loss of stock due to fire. Okay, there will be particulars. There is an amount called value of stock on the date of fire. What is the amount? The amount which you are getting from the closing stock of memorandum, which is 54,600, right? So 54,600. Add value of abnormal goods. Value of abnormal goods. What is the amount of abnormal goods? The amount of abnormal goods, see, in valuing the balance sheet, it has been written off a certain stock which was poor selling line having cost of 6,900. The cost is 6,900. Next, you see, a portion of these goods were sold at a loss of 300 on the original cost is 3,500. So the portion is 3,500. You deduct this from 6,900 to 3,500, you will be getting 3,400, which is actually the value of abnormal goods. If you add it with 54,600, it is coming 58,000, which is basically the total value of stock on the date of fire. Okay, this is the total value of stock on the date of fire, which is 58,000. Okay, now whatever the salvage value you have saved, it has been given. The salvage value has been rupees 6,000. So value of goods salvaged, which is 6,000. You deduct that, you will get in rupees 52,000 as your gross claim. Is your gross claim. Now see, here also average clause has been applied. How? Average clause means
the company has a fire policy of 43,500. Means fire policy is 43,500 and insurable value will be the value of stock on the date of fire, which is the total value, which is 58,000. See, insurable value is greater than the policy value, which is 43,500. So obviously there is an under insurance and definitely average clause will be applicable over here. So in this case, when average clause is applicable, net claim can be constructed. So I have to write this. How you can write that? See here, insurable value is rupees 58,000. Policy value is rupees 43,500 as insurable value is greater than policy value, there is an under insurance. I'm writing in a different form, but you can write like that in the previous class, whatever I have written. There is an under insurance, and so average clause will be applicable, right? Therefore, net claim is equal to gross claim into policy value by insurable value. Gross claim is 52,000 to policy value 43,500 and insurable value is 58,000. So 52,000 into 43,500 divided by 58,000. You are getting 39,000, which is the net claim. Means you can claim maximum of rupees 39,000 from the insurance company. So this is one type of sum where abnormal goods adjustments has been given. It's very important. This type of sum came in different exams, different types, different times. So this is sum number 17 of your today's work. I hope you will understand, and in the next class I will be doing a different sum. Thank you for patient hearing. Have a nice day ahead.